Now the last topic of the first unit is application of list, that is polynomial manipulation. Application of linked list. Linked list can be used to represent polynomials and the different operations that can be performed on them. Usually the different operations means adding two polynomials or subtracting two polynomials. That we will see in the next coming slides. Generally the polynomials are represented in memory using a linked list. Every individual term in a polynomial generally consists of two parts. I hope everyone know polynomial adining equation eduthukittave ovvoru individual term nim pathina rendu parts irukum. One is we call it as coefficient, another one is we call it as a power. But for example 9x to the power 3, 9 abingiradhu coefficient, power 3 ingiradhu vandu we generally call it as power. So if in the example pathina you can better understand, consider a polynomial 6x to the power 3 plus 9x to the power 2 plus 7x to the power 1 plus 1, and the 1 abingiradhu pathina which is nothing but 1x to the power 0 abdinu kuda namba imagine panrom, anything to the power 0 is 1. So here this 6, 9, 7, 1 we call it as coefficient, then 3, 2, 1 and 0 are the powers. Here the first term 6x to the power 3, here this 6 we call it as coefficient and to the power 3 we call it as power. Similarly in the second term also there are two things, 9 is the coefficient, 2 is the power. Similarly in the third term 7 is the coefficient and x to the power 1, that is 1 is the power. Here if you take 1 which is nothing but 1 x to the power 0. Now how we can represent this polynomial equation in a linked list, this is an example. You just see this linked list, it is a singly linked list. As usual start is a special pointer which points to the first term, and this term which in turn connected with the second, and again second to third and third to fourth. Now this polynomial equation consists of four terms. First term is 6x to the power 3, 6 is the coefficient and 3 is the power. So we just use the first data field consisting of coefficient, the second data field consisting of the power, and as usual the third one which is the pointer which points to the next. Similarly the second term 9 is the coefficient, 2 is the power, and in the third term 7 is the coefficient, 1 is the power, and finally in the last term 1 is the coefficient. As I already told, x to the power 0, adhaadu 1 abdingiradhu enna na 1 x to the power 0 abdin artham. So appo what is the power? 0. So 0. Finally the last element is null value. So this is the linked list representation of a one polynomial equation. Now we see what is the structure of the node for this polynomial equation. In singly linked list, in circularly linked list and doubly linked list we have already seen. Now this is our polynomial equation. Each node comprises three portions. One, first two are data field and third one is the pointer to the next. So what is the definition of the structure? So struct node, open curly braces and finally close curly braces. Here we have to write the members of the node. So what is the first field? As we already mentioned, this is the coefficient of the first term, this is power of the first term, this is the pointer to the next term. So how we can define? First one is coefficient, here it is an integer, so I just declare int coefficient. Second term which is representing a power, once again it is an integer, so what is the second element of this node? Int power. What is the third term? It is a pointer which points to the next node. How we can declare this pointer? So struct node star next. So this is the definition of a node. Now we see example. Consider two equation. Equation 1, 6x to the power 4 plus 5x to the power 2 plus 7x to the power 1 plus 1. Similarly, equation 2, 3x to the power 3, x plus x square plus 2x plus 4. Now we are going to add these two equations and we are going to subtract each other. Generally, we are writing a polynomial equation in the order of power in descending order. That is, power should be from maximum value to the minimum value. That is, the last term with power 0 and the first term with maximum power. So, in the equation 1, equation 2, in the first equation, 6x to the power 4 is the maximum power. In my answer, 6x to the power 4. And because second equation, there is no term with power 4. So, 6x to the power. Then, next maximum power in these two equations, x to the power 3. X to the power 3 only in equation 2. So, what is my answer? 3x to the power 3 is one of the term. Then x to the power 2, which is available both in equation 1 as well as in equation 2. In addition, this 5 and 1 get added. So 6x to the power 2. And then the next power term, 7x, 2x, x to the power 1 in both the terms. So we can add each other. So 9x to the power 1. And finally, the final answer term is 1 here, it is 4, we just add, it will be 5. So, what is our resultant equation after adding these two polynomial? 6x to the power 4, 3x to the power 3, 6x to the power 2, 9x to the power 1 and 5. Similarly, 6x to the power 4 is the only term available in equation 1. There is no x to the power 4 in equation 2. So, 6x to the power 4. X to the power 3 only available in equation 2. It is not available in equation 1. So, my answer is second term is 3x to the power 3. But whereas x to the power 2 is available in both equation 1 as well as equation 2. Now, the subtraction to be happen. So, 5 minus 1. So, 4x to the power 2. And when x to the power 1 is available both in equation 1 as well as equation 2, while we go for subtraction, 7 minus 2, 5x. And here the term is 1, in second it will be 4, so 1 minus 4, it is minus 3. So my answer is 6x to the power 4, 3x to the power 3, 4x to the power 2, 5x minus 3. So I hope you understand what is the problem we are going to solve in the next coming slides. So, we are getting an input for equation 1 and we are going to get the equation for 2 and then we are going to add and we are going to subtract. So, what is this equivalent linked list representation? So, what is equation 1? 6x to the power 4, 5x square plus 7x plus 1. How we can represent this? 6x to the power 4, 5x to the power 2, 7x to the power 1, 1 plus 1. So, this is the equation, this is the linked list representation of the polynomial 1. And similarly, for the polynomial 2, this is the linked list representation. So, after adding these two polynomial equation, the resultant linked list representation is like this. 6x to the power 4, 3x to the power 3, 6x to the power 2, 9x plus 5. Similarly, after subtracting the first two polynomials, my resultant linked list is like this. 6x to the power 4 minus 3x to the power 3 plus 4x to the power 2 plus 5x to the power 1 minus 3. Now, we see the C program to implement the polynomial equation. First header file, it is similar to that of a singly linked list, stdio.h we have to include, and stdlib, because for memory allocation we are in need of stdlib.h. Second, node should be defined, that is what we discussed two slides before. Struct node, one part is coefficient, another one is power, and third one is pointer to the next node. Next one is we have to declare all global variables and functions in the global declaration section. So, here we are using some four pointers, start 1, start 2, start 3, start 4. In singly linked list and circularly linked list as well as in doubly linked list, we are using only one start pointer, that is name it as start. But here why we are in need of four start pointers? Now you just see that linked list representation once again. This is polynomial equation 1, this is for polynomial equation 2. After we add these two, we are getting this result. So this is sum polynomial. And after subtracting first and second, we are getting list. So for each linked list, we are in need of one start pointer. For this start pointer, here also we need one start pointer. Here also we need one start pointer. Similarly, here also we need one start pointer. Because single start pointer cannot point to the first node of all the list. So for this equation, we need start 1, for this start 2, for this start 3, for this start 4. So that's why we declare 4 start pointers. One for polynomial equation 1, one for polynomial equation 2, next one is for sum of 2 polynomial equation, and start 4 is for difference of 2 polynomial equation. And remaining functions, it is very similar to that of singly linked list. We have to create a polynomial, because in the program first we have to create polynomial equation 1 and then create polynomial equation 2, then only we can go for sum and difference. So for create polynomial we need one function, so this is for create polynomial. And after we are doing all the process, finally we have to display the polynomial, so we go for this function called display polynomial. And for add polynomial one function and subtract polynomial one function. And there is one more function called add node. What is the purpose of this add node? Which is very similar to that of create function. In create polynomial is used for creating the original polynomial equation 1 and original polynomial equation 2. But in sum operation and subtraction operation, that is in addition and subtraction, we have to create a new polynomial equation. For that we are in need of one function called add node. The working of this all these functions can be better understood in the coming slides. As usual, after global declaration is over, we have to go for main function. Normally the main function is used for displaying the main menu. First thing is display the main menu. So enter the first option is first polynomial, enter the first polynomial. Second option, enter the second polynomial. And after we enter second polynomial, normally we go for add polynomials. And once we add two polynomials, we just display the resultant polynomial. And next operation, we can subtract the polynomial. Similarly, we just display the result. And finally, we go for exit. And once the menu is displayed, obviously we go for getting the enter the option. That is, for that one printf statement and one scanf statement we used. So what will be the next statement according to you? You just guess. Yes, exactly correct. So next one is we go for switch block. So in that option, if the option is 1, what we have to do? If case 1, we have to call the create polynomial function for creating the first polynomial. In case 2, we are calling the same create polynomial function for second polynomial equation. And for the third operation, we go for add polynomial function. Once add polynomial function is called, after the process is over, we just print one statement, polynomial is added. And in case 4, I just display the polynomial. After addition is performed, what we have to do? We have to display the answer. So display the answer means, for better understandability and readability, I just write like this. Enna pannirukonu pathina ipo na add panniyaachu enak answer venum. Answer eppadi irukonu? Polynomial equation 1 enna, polynomial equation 2 enna, idu rendu add pannadukku appuram enak resultant polynomial equation eppadi irukku appdin vandhaadhaan and the readability or user ah paakumbodhu we can clearly understand. Just answer mattum potta prayojanam illa. So polynomial equation 1 அப்படினு print ஆயிட்டு என்ன பண்ணனும், display polynomial function call பண்ணி என்ன print பண்ணனும், start 1 I already told, it is representing start 1 is a pointer which points to the starting node of the first polynomial, start 2 for second polynomial, and star 3 is for resultant polynomial, that is addition of two polynomials oda answer star 3 point panniterukom. So idu moone print pannomna our purpose is solved here. What is case 5? Sub poly, that is subtraction of polynomial equation. So after subtraction of polynomial equation execution over, I just print the statement polynomial subtractor. Then what is case 6? Subtract pannadukaprom what I have to do, I have to print polynomial equation 1, polynomial equation 2, and final the resultant polynomial equation. Similarly additional eppadi pannuvom adhe dhaan. Finally the case 7 is exit of 0. So it is written in a do while statement, while option not equal to 7. Now we see the function definition of create polynomial. So the function name is create poly, almost 90% same as that of singly linked list creation. You just compare this with singly linked list creation, you can better understand. There are two pointers, one is new node, another one is PTR, and we are getting an input for the coefficient part and the power part by using the printf and scanf functions. We are allocating a memory for new node, we are allocating a memory by using malloc function. This coefficient value and power value should be supplied to the particular node. For example, if you imagine this is the node, now the new node is created, this is my new node. So this is, we call it as coefficient part, and this is, we call it as power part, this is the next part. Now we have to supply the value of this C here. So for that we are writing a statement, new node of coefficient is equal to C, and we have to supply the value of P here. So for that we are writing a statement, new node of power is equal to P, and what next, new node of next is equal to null. Creation, what I said, it is nothing but insertion at the end. We are creating a node for each term. For example, in my polynomial equation there are 4 terms are there, we are going to create 4 nodes. First node is for the first term, another node second term, third node for the third term, and fourth node for the fourth term. Each node should be added at the end, so it is similar to that of insertion at the end. So in creation, in singly linked list itself, we said for the first node creation we are using this if block, in that is if start is equal to null means, which represent the creator node is the first node. So for that this is the statement, and remaining part we go for else part. So this is the else part. By using a pointer variable, we just move the pointer variable to the end of the existing linked list, and finally that pointer of next is equal to new node, so we can accomplish the insertion at the end. Now once again we are going to get the next coefficient. If the coefficient is -1, we can break and come out of the while loop, because here we give the condition, whenever you are entering -1 as the coefficient of the polynomial equation, we have to come out. If suppose this coefficient value is not -1, automatically we have to get the power, and once we go for that while loop, this will be repetitive, and finally once we enter this -1, it is come out of the while loop. Then here it is going to return the start. So what is the start now? The start is the address of the newly created, that is for polynomial equation 1. While I am creating a first polynomial, that should be pointed by start 1. While I am creating a second polynomial, it should be pointed by start 2. After both the polynomials are added, it should be returned the address of the first node, which will be stored in start 3. Once the polynomial is subtracted, it should be returned the value, which will be stored in start 4.